Or you gonna continue to stay in the same messed up situation? Or you gonna make your mind up that you gonna rise up, amen, and go forward? And so it was on Pentecost, amen, where they were in the upper room and they were tarrying, they were waiting on God. But the Bible said there came a sound from heaven. Tell your neighbors and neighbor, when I go to church, I want to hear from heaven. Oh, I like the praise team and the music is good, but if God don't show up, we just a group of people here, amen, that's making a bunch of noise. I want to feel God. I want to feel the God of Elijah that answered by fire. Oh, I want to feel the God that blinded Paul when he was on the Damascus Road. Is there anybody know what I'm talking about? I want to feel the God that can take a dope fiend and a prostitute, a drug addict, and a crook, and a thief, and a whoremonger, and straight them up. I don't care what folks say about you. That ain't what you are, but God declare, amen, that you're clean and you're healed. God said, if you would just answer the call, I can take the taste right out of your mouth. I can take nicotine out of your mouth. You don't need to eat cigarette. You just need to give up the cigarettes. Is there anybody know just what I'm talking about? If you won't get gone, then you got to do something different. He said, the day that you hear my voice, he said, you got the heart, not your heart. Is there anybody in here know what I'm talking about? Why? Because what you've been doing, and y'all can finish it, it sure ain't working, baby. I done tried everything. I done tried a little bit of everybody. I done tried doing it this way, and I done tried doing it that way. And God said, when you gonna try my way? When you gonna let me have the wheel? You've been driving a car. Hey, man, you done ran you down in the ditch, and you still don't want to come to yourself. You know, ran through three red lights, amen, and you know, went through a stop sign. And God says, stop, because I got a word for you. Is there anybody know what I'm talking about in here? When you get sick and tired of being sick and tired, you will do something about your situation. And so the Bible said, when they heard this, you know, them folk that went going to church, but they ain't never heard this. See, I ain't heard it, never heard it like that. It's something about that word of God that will make your hair stand up on your head. It's something about that word of God where you got to get in the mirror and look at yourself. You got to have a David experience when he, amen, slept with the Bathsheba, took another man's wife, and God came to him and he said, there was a one man that had one little ewe lamb, and there was a king that had everything, and he took the one lamb from the man, and David said, that man should have died. And the prophet said, you are the man, you are the one. And the problem with many of us is we don't like to be told, amen, when we are the one, because we think that we are being bad at 21 plus. But tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I heard the prophet say that for me and my house, we gonna serve the Lord. And serving them means obeying him. Serving them means worshiping him. Serving them means giving God some glory. Is there anybody in here know what I'm talking about? Because what I've been doing, it ain't working. And when you get tired, somebody said, when you get tired, you will change your ways. When you get tired, you will try something else. When you get tired, you will say like the old mother said, Jesus, just as I am, I was wounded and I'm weary. I'm sick and far from the peaceful shore. I'm looking to rise no more. But I heard Jesus call my name. Touch your neighbor. Say, Jesus is calling your name. And the question I want to know is, will you answer when he calls you? There was a prophet in the Bible by the name of young Samuel. And when God got ready to call him, he thought somebody else was calling him. And every time he got, he went to his father and said, Daddy, did you call me? And he says, no, my son. But there's a clarion call of God that will make you forsake everything. There's a clarion call of God that will make you give up a girlfriend that you had for 30 years. There's a clarion call control that will make you put the alcohol down and make you put the dope down and make you put the sex down and make you value yourself. There is a call.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory, Jesus.
Oh, I'm in the wrong church because you don't want to be told that God is calling you. You don't want to be told that God got something for you. You don't want to let it go. But the only way you can get it, baby, is you got to let it go. Amen. You're holding up your miracle. You're holding up your destiny. Why? Because you don't want to let it go.
Oh, Jesus. I see it up. Oh, something.
Now, when they heard this,
glory to Jesus.
Somebody said, what was the this? This was the word of God. They were pricked in their hearts. In other words, they were touched in their heart. I don't know if you ever came to church. When I got saved, it was something that touched my heart. Hey, God wants your heart. Because when God gets your heart, he gets everything. If your heart is messed up, God can't get to you. But when you got the right heart.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes. Glory to God.
Yeah, yeah. He wants your heart. He wants to soften your heart. Tell your neighbor, say you need a heart transplant. You need open heart surgery. God got to cut you. Tell your neighbor, he got to cut you down your heart and crack your chest open. Amen. And operate on your heart because your heart is the very essence. It is the very you because the Bible says out of the heart flows the issues of life.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory. Amen, Jesus.
God wants your heart.
He does. Amen.
They were pricked. Who was the day? It was the church folks. You see, Jesus had a lot of fans, but he had very few followers.
Jesus.
Look at your neighbor and say, are you a fan or are you a follower? Because if you are a follower, it's going to cost you something. But if you are a fan, you just show up for the entertainment. You didn't show up because the praise team sing. You didn't show up because the preacher sound good. You didn't show up because, but God don't want you to show up. God is looking for followers.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory, Jesus.
The Bible said foxes have holes, birds have nests, but the Son of Man had nowhere to lay his head. See, on this journey with following God, you're not going to know where he's leading you sometime. But when you got faith, you got the rest assured that God's going to lead you in the right direction. And the apostle said, and the rest of the apostles said, men and brethren, what shall we do? What shall we do? And they said, what you going to do with this? What are you going to do with this word? I don't care what your friends say. What are you going to do with this word? I don't care what the people in the church say. God said, what are you going to do with me? And then Peter said, repent. He's calling the church to repentance. And repentance just means that I'm sorry.
Yes.
I want to change. See, you can't change if you ain't sorry. You can't change if you don't admit that you're in trouble. You can't change if you don't admit that you need help.
Yes, yes, Lord.
What shall we do? What are we going to do? Man, if I'm in the ditch and you in the ditch, man, we need to find somebody to help us get out of the ditch. If I'm drowning, if I can't swim, amen, and you drown, and it's me jumping over, I'm going to drown myself. I'm going to throw you the life raft. That's how Jesus is. Jesus has been throwing some of y'all the life raft, and you've been drowning.
My God.
You've been drowning with the problems of life, but you still won't surrender. And he throws the raft out for you every week, trying to pull you in. He said, just grab on to the life raft.
Ooh, Jesus.
Just grab on to the lifeline. And when you do that, he will pull you in. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? He says to repent. In other words, repentance doesn't mean, amen, it means that you want to turn from something. It means that you want to give up something. It means that you want to give up something that's valuable. If it don't mean anything to you, then it don't mean anything to God. Because God wants that thing. He wants that it. And everybody of us have an it in our life that God wants it. And we keep giving God everything else, and God said, that ain't what I want. God said, I want it. I want that thing, amen, that you value the most. I want you to turn from that, because if you turn from that, I can open up glory, and you will be filled with the power of the Holy Ghost. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? And then he told every one of them to be baptized in the name of Jesus. And I was sharing, amen, if you don't join the church by shaking somebody's hand, no, you have to be born into the church. You have to be baptized. You know what? Baptism is a symbol to all of us that now in your friends and your buddies and your cup buddies, amen, that you have taken on the name of Jesus. It was Paul that said, I'm not ashamed of the gospel. If God said, if you be ashamed of me, I'm going to be ashamed of you. You need to stop worrying about folk and what they think about you. Amen. You need to be more concerned about what God is thinking about you. That's a problem, man. You can't do nothing in life because you're worrying about what they think about you and what they gonna say. And they talking about me, they supposed to talk about you. If you a child of God, somebody's always gonna be talking about you and messing with you. But if you on the devil's side, ain't nobody worrying about you because you ain't no threat. Amen. But when you make your mind up, you gonna go through hell.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, yes, Lord.
Ooh. Yeah. He said everybody. He didn't just say one of us. He said everybody. And repentance is just not for the sinner. It's for the sake too, because there's sometimes when you as a Christian, you get out of bounds, you get off board. Amen. You say something you ain't got no business said. You do things that you ain't got no business doing. Amen. And you the last one to figure out, amen, that you're on the wrong road. Everybody else see it, but they afraid, amen, to tell you. But I'm going to tell you about yourself. You need to repent, and when the time of refreshing will come, and God will bring you out.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Tell your neighbor, the only person stopping you is you.
Lord,
can't nobody stop you from getting what God got for you. Don't nobody in here have no monopoly on God. Can stop your blessing. Can stop God from blessing you and doing what he needs to do for you. You're the one stopping you because you won't repent. You won't change. You won't turn. You won't give it up. And that's why God can't bless you. God said, I want to bless you. Amen. But you won't give it up. You won't turn to me. I've been calling you in the midnight hour. I don't know if you know when God calls you. Amen. He'll speak to you when you do something wrong. He'll convict you because God got his hand on you. It's a terrible thing to get to a place where you can't feel nothing no more. Where you're just hard. You're just rough. You're just mean. No sensitivity. No nothing. But God said you got to soften your heart. Because when they heard this, they heard it. I'm getting older now. I ain't got time to play.
Amen.
Just we only got 35 more years on this earth. I got to make the best 35. I ain't got time to be all stressed out. I ain't got time to be worrying about people who don't want to go nowhere. I ain't got time to be running with chickens. Amen. I want to soar with the eagles. Is there anybody here talking about? I ain't got time to spend 10 more years waiting for you to get it together when you've already been here 14 and you still haven't gotten together. I ain't even got another year to journey with you. Find me somebody that want God. I can work with somebody that want God. You ain't even got to be able to read, spell, or whatever. But if your heart is right, God can reach you. If your mind is right, God can reach you. If you're willing, God can reach you. Stop looking at your situation. God said, I caused trouble to come into your life. Ain't nothing you can do is going to go right until you surrender to me, baby. I don't care if you get a new Boaz, a new boo. That's going to go sour after a year. God said, it is not a man that you need. It's me that you need. God said, you need me. It's not a drink that you need. It's not drugs. It's not sex. God said, you need me.
Lord, I need you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.